There we go. Hey, Shelly. Hey, Angie. Hey, Kimberly. Hey, Connie. Saw your earlier video today. It certainly is a lot going on at your place. Oh, yeah. We're going to dive into it a little bit today. Try and not shake the table. Hi, Patty. Everyone go hit the like button. It helps the channel. Yes, thank you. It does. It helps promote the videos. Hi, Angie from East Texas. Makes a little house in the country. Thank you. Dwight, he says, hi to my fellow Stinson owner and pilot from Oro Valley, Arizona. Hold on here, just one second. I'm trying to get this other. Hey, there we go. We just got Facebook on here. Marcy's running around trying to find the other phone holder. It grew legs and it walked away, meaning Harvey or Paxton picked it up and walked away with it. So we have no idea where it is. we were fellow Stinson owners, but we no longer are. My dad actually sold the Stinson probably 4 or 5 months ago, which is a huge bummer. Hey, will you turn on the light when you get a sec? So that is a bummer. Hi, Kimberly from Queensland, Australia. There you go. Can you guys see me now? Oh, much better. Hi, Tina. Hi, Alaska Lady 58 from Alaska. Hi, Gloria. Hey, Russell. Welcome, you guys. Hopefully, you guys are having a good Thursday. The weekend is almost here. That's way too high. You would think we are amateurs at this.
No,
half of the time. Half of the time we go. Did you look under the couch?
It went under the couch.
Yeah, it would. Hi, Crandall and Marcy from Ohio. Hi, Joni. Hi, Carrie from Massachusetts. Terry from snow-covered Wisconsin. Oh, yeah. Didn't you guys just get up there, Midwest? Didn't you guys just get a bunch of snow and stuff, this cold little cold snap? Hi, Susie from Indiana. Hi, Christy. Hi, Phyllis from Toronto. Gloria says, hey, I see you from Virginia Beach. Welcome, welcome. Man, it was a hot one today. I was out working in the yard, as I'm sure you guys can tell. If you haven't seen our last video, by the way, go back after this live is done, go watch it. It's fabulous. We actually just had the UPS guy drop off a package and he was testing out our new driveway. So it's mailman approved. He said, I think I can make it. I did notice I need to make it a little bit bigger in one spot. So I'm glad he was here to drive through it so that I could make some adjustments. Hi, Joy from Bristow, Oklahoma, just up the street. Terry says, yes, 7 inches of snow for my birthday. Hey, happy birthday. And oh my gosh, I would not be happy about that birthday present, but maybe you are. Hi, Denise from Rhode Island. Man, thank you guys so much for jumping on here with us and joining with us. Pat from Southeastern Oklahoma. Hey, you're just down the street from us. Just dropped that. Hi, Missy. Hi, Wendell. Gloria, how are the boys doing? Are they enjoying the warm weather? Yes, they are enjoying the warm weather, but both Paxton and Harvey right now are getting teeth. They're getting their molars and their canines, and it has been absolutely bonkers. They've done pretty good, but you can tell that they're in a lot of pain. They're uncomfortable. They don't want to eat. This, that, and the other. And so that's kind of made things a little bit difficult. But they've been doing really good. Angela says, we got a lot of snow last night, but turned to rain, thankfully. Hello from cold and rainy Illinois, Monica. Valerie says, I'm still confused, Crandall. Sorry, I probably started on a train of thought and then got distracted. I tend to do that a lot if you guys are new here. Michelle, hi, Crandall from upstate New York. Joni says, there's a lot of flooding around here. I live in Ohio, about 50 miles from Pittsburgh, and the flooding around the stadium is horrible. Oh man, I had no idea. Holy cow. We've been giving the boys Tylenol, going back to that. They have, like I said, they're getting teeth. Marcy, you have to have the phone on it for it to work.
Right. Really?
Yeah. Okay, give us 1 second here.
Did not know that.
Yeah.
Sorry, everybody. He just turned you all off.
Oh, whoa. Are we back?
Sorry. Close your eyes.
Goodness gracious. Wow.
Close your eyes. I'm so sorry. Wow, my hair is awful.
Okay. Is this... What is going on here? This is not working. Okay. Now we're upside down.
But are we upside down for everybody else? Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's your phone's too heavy for it. It doesn't work.
Okay, we're not gonna do that.
That was a roller coaster ride. Gosh dang, I hate this, Mars.
Well, I don't know what to tell you.
Corey Brown, howdy from Phoenix. Nancy, WV in the house. I feel like an idiot that I don't know what that abbreviation is for. I'm sorry. Pamelia says, good evening from Burlington, Vermont. We got 8.8 inches of snow and more still coming. Oh my goodness, that's crazy. Sorry about that, Facebook. You guys did get seasick. That was a lot of going around like crazy. Sorry about that. Jamie says, so happy to catch you live from Ohio. Man, it's so good to be with you guys. We do a live every Thursday night at 8 o'clock, and we've been doing pretty good. I think we haven't even missed a week this year, which is pretty impressive. We're doing pretty good. Kathy, hey fam, from Nevada. Yeah, welcome Eldredge fam. You guys are all part of the family. And Brenda says, Marcy, we come to see your beautiful face, not your hair. She'll be in here in a second. Like I said, the kids have been, they're actually having a little bit of a rough night getting to sleep for some reason. Hopefully they will, actually they have settled down quite a bit. Frozen waffles for teething. Oh, we have actually been feeding them frozen French toast. So that has been good. WV, West Virginia. That could be West Virginia. Oh, West Virginia is WV. Okay, good. Thank you guys. I had no idea. I felt like an idiot.
I thought you said WV.
Yeah, I had no idea what that meant.
Well, I feel like you didn't really want me here with you because you didn't leave a space for me.
Okay, hold on. We're gonna have to slide this back. Ugh. Wow. Okay, next week we are gonna be more prepared because...
Okay, we gotta tell them what we were doing and why we like jumped on and everything.
That's okay, this will work. Hey from KCMO. Okay, what the heck? What's with the acronyms, y'all? That can't be a real one. KCMO.
Kansas City.
Missouri.
KCM. Yeah, Kansas City, Missouri.
Is that a real place?
I think so.
Okay.
There's Kansas City, Kansas, and Kansas City, Missouri. But you gotta take your arm off the table because you
Because I'm shaking it.
Both cameras.
Hi, Marcos. Hey, Sue. Hi, Hannah. Juliet says it was 80 degrees here in South Louisiana. Yeah, it was 80 degrees today. I got sun. Y'all probably can't tell, but I cooked.
He came home and he was so like,
yeah, I literally took a nap while you were gone. I literally laid down on the couch.
Wondering what you did.
And I just fell asleep because I was so over
that,
it.
The house is the exact same. When I
Zan, never to fear, Zan is here. Thanks, Zan. Zan always jumps on you guys. He's one of our very loyal subscribers.
He's our OG goat.
Yeah, he's our OG goat. He is from Australia. He gets on. I mean, he comments on every video. He comments on, or he's on every live. He may have missed like one or two, but he sticks with us strong. He even changed his name to Zan the Goat when we got rid of Zan. So... Cindy says, hey, Zan, I was worried about you. Marsh, you just shook the table.
That was you.
Nope, I don't think so.
That was you.
Oil of cloves is great for teething. That's weird. Huh. Dawn says, go Chiefs. The Chiefs won the Super Bowl, so you're probably pretty happy.
We give them frozen peas and frozen corn and frozen ice, like little ice pellets.
So Juliet says, I'm sitting outside on my patio and we'll have to go inside because the mosquitoes are biting. We got wrecked today.
No, I.
Okay, you got wrecked.
I got wrecked.
I don't get bit today by mosquitoes very much.
I'm like itching all over. I just had to go change my shirt. But I have like the two on my head hurt really bad. And then there's one on my kneecap. And
we were working outside and told Mars, slap your cheek. Because there was a mosquito on it. So yeah, the mosquitoes are out strong now. And we are ready for. I don't know what you can do about mosquitoes. Really nothing.
Well, like when we're next to our house, okay, we can put mosquito repellent on, which I didn't think about because
I didn't
it was
either.
Like.
It's the first time we've been out and got.
No, eaten. I got 2 days ago when I went outside for just a little bit with you.
Huh.
But I went out and it was still like bright and sunny. It wasn't even like dusk yet. What time was it? We went out at 6:30. So I guess it was like sunset. And I was helping Crandall. And we went out and worked together. We had a babysitter come over to our house and watch our kids for an hour so that we could go do some manual labor.
Yeah, get some work done.
Really what he meant is he drives the skid steer and I do all the manual labor and I break not one, but two nails. See, look. Two nails.
Dang, Mars, I'm sorry.
It's fine. I'm just going to glue them back on.
Nice. Well, in today's live, we have got quite a few things to talk about. If you guys got questions, go down, throw it in the comments. We'll try and catch every question that comes through the comments so that we have a time to engage and talk with you guys. But we're going to talk about the greenhouse. We're going to talk about the pond. We're going to talk about the front yard. We're going to talk about what else?
The front yard.
Paxton and Harvey's doctor's appointment today. All of that is going to be in today's live. So buckle up. This is going to be a good one.
Of homesteading life.
And your newest, what?
Attempt at homesteading life.
And Marcy's newest attempt at homesteading life. That's pretty good. Which one do you want to start with?
You start. I just got to hold this down for a little bit.
Okay. We are going to start off with the greenhouse. The greenhouse is great. It's withstood everything so far. It's not, I would say it's probably 75% done. It's the frame is up. The windows are up. The front of it is done. It's basically, I've got to go on and put a skirting around it.
You know, we never like went back and painted it a second time, right?
Yeah, we do need to do some paint touch up. That's for sure. Yeah.
And maybe the doors.
And
maybe
and
the
doors.
Handles.
Everybody
doors.
Says, yeah, that's why I said, I didn't say it was done. It's got some fine stuff to be finished.
But Crandall, the thing is if I didn't like let you know that I know it's not done, it would be like some projects in our house that it's been 2 years since you touched
them. No. I want to get the greenhouse done. We are past ready to plant.
Yeah.
But the opportunity and stuff with the skid steer came up right, obviously, when we were towards the tail end of that project. And so now I've had to jump over and do that while we have it because we only have it for a certain amount of time.
To be honest, obviously, we could have planted in the greenhouse, but when it goes to our other garden, we've got two frosts since then, so like...
Yeah, our main garden, our outdoor garden.
It hasn't been too bad. Okay, I'm all done now.
Okay, good. So, that's kind of what's going on. Oh, hi, Kim, Steinmetz Family Farm friend here. Thanks for joining with us.
Hi.
Hi, E-Fam, Paula says. So excited to see all you're doing on your homestead. Thank you. It does feel good, doesn't it, to like...
Oh, to make progress.
To make progress.
And going back to the greenhouse, because that's what we were talking about, it was so cute today to, like, look outside and see Maverick, like, run in there to go play. And, like, he just has all of his tractors and everything set up.
I got some of the sand from when we were digging out the pond, and I put it in there. It's, like, dirt sand, but it's pretty dang sandy, and he's been loving driving that in his truck.
We're fixed. Don't worry.
Looking good, Mars.
Thanks.
Looking good. Amanda says, hey guys, I'm the one that drew the Christmas card for y'all. I live in Rome, Georgia. Your yard and pond are looking amazing. The boys sure are growing. Love y'all. Thanks, Amanda.
Thank you
so much. Yeah, we loved that. That was an amazing Christmas card. Corey Anderson says, does anyone have to put their garbage out? Y'all, I was out working on the front yard today, and what comes driving by? The trash truck. Our week has been very mixed up, and we both forgot the trash. So.
I honestly, like, have been reminding myself all day to take it out tonight, and I think that's because we used to do lives on Wednesday night.
And we would get reminded. You guys reminded us. And now,
but I haven't forgot. I've been the one responsible for it, like, the last
Marcia's been doing really
2 good. 2 months. And today, this is why, because my focus was on not forgetting that we had the doctors this morning. So I completely spaced taking out the trash. I don't know what we're going to do.
Yeah.
So but it's like, okay, I know it's not that big of a deal, and I'm glad it's not the middle of summer, but diapers stink.
Yeah.
Like, that's, you guys have had one kid, that's four weeks of diapers sitting in our trash can.
4 weeks?
Yeah, we have 2 kids.
Oh.
If they have one
2 kid, weeks, yeah. Yeah,
it's
okay.
2 weeks automatically, and then it's 4 weeks.
I guess that makes sense.
That's a lot of diapers.
Hi, Kelly. Especially another Steinmetz family farm member here. Thank you so much, Kelly, for joining with us. So that's, I guess we got it. We got to stay on track, Marce. So the greenhouse, it's going great. Like we said, there are some stuff we want to get done on it. We've got some plants to plant. We've got all of these different ideas and things that are going on in there that we're going to be doing. In fact, I think tomorrow I'll probably be spending some time out there getting things organized, and we got to get some stuff planted. So Marcy said she's going to go out and weed the garden tomorrow, which I was pretty surprised about.
No, I said, I will go out. If you show me something that you want me to do, I'll go out and do it. But, like, you have to show me, because I would be the one to, like, pull up all of our plants.
We don't have a garden anymore because Marcy pulled it all out.
So.
No, it's
I
pretty easy. All of our.
I'm going to be the one to go pick that strawberry tomorrow, which means really I'll let Maverick pick the strawberry tomorrow. But
our strawberries are red and producing, y'all.
I just want to know, like, are they going to produce more than one strawberry a day? Because at this point, it's kind of anticlimactic.
Well, we need a bunch more plants, and yes.
I thought that was a lot.
No, we need, like, 10 times that many.
I'll just buy them from the store.
Yeah, well, they're cheap right now. Marcy, we'll get into that. Marcy's new homesteading kick. So, yeah, that's the update on the greenhouse. It's going good. The door, everything is there. Everything's functional. It's just, like she said, door handles. We are going to paint the doors. I think you guys convinced me. And, you know, getting the dirt in and getting some flower beds made and stuff. So, I'm excited about it. Are you excited about it?
Painting the doors?
No, getting the greenhouse done. So, yeah, I guess painting the greenhouse doors. That's another thing you can do.
Honestly, I feel like I can't move past, like, getting a place to park.
A driveway?
A driveway,
yeah.
Like,
I do. I want our driveway done. Which it's
75% there.
If
well,
I have half
minus
a day,
the rock.
Well, yeah, but we're not going to get the rock. Like, we're going to, if I have half a day, it will be functional again.
Yeah.
I mean, it technically is now, but.
You can just drive on it. But, like,
we want
our neighbor who came over to watch our kids was also like, do I go out your front door or do I go out your back door?
I know. Well, she came up to the back door when she.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. No wonder why she, like, I was like, oh, you can go out that door when she left.
Oh.
And she's like, oh, are you sure? And I was like, yeah.
It's funny. Here in the country, people go out the front door, in the front door, out the back door, whatever.
So.
It's pretty funny. So, anyways, yeah, so that's what's going on with the greenhouse. Do you want to now talk about your new homesteading kick?
Okay, so on, what day did I go? What day did you go? 2 days ago? Tuesday night, Crandall decided he was going to go look for some sheds that's not like gardening sheds, like antler sheds.
Yeah, deer antlers.
And some morel mushrooms. And I just decided Crandall sucks at that. So, sorry. You're really good at morels when you go to your morel spot.
Yeah.
But not so good on this shed hunting thing.
Yeah. Last year I killed it. I found like 15.
I know,
this year I haven't found any.
You also like went way more.
Way more. Way
more. Okay.
Yeah.
So Crandall decided to go do that, but I was taking the kids. So we were like halfway to Sam's Club. So I took the kids and we went and got dinner at Sam's Club. And I went to go pick up some fruit because you guys know I got little fruit boys. And I go in and the fruit, like for the container that's 2 pounds of strawberries was like $2.59. And I was like, Crandall, normally I pay for like the one pint size. I pay $2.19 is like the best price you can get it. And so I bought three of them. And we made homemade jam yesterday, me and Maverick. And then today we made strawberry syrup.
We should go grab one and show everybody.
It's pretty cute.
Because it turned out really good.
So, they turned out really cute. We had a lot of fun.
Oh, whoa, it's separated. Oh, no, these ones are way...
That's the other one. Grab the other one.
That's bonkers. Is that all separated? You got your gelatin, your liquid, and then your strawberries.
Grab the other one. He grabbed the empty container. And these are going into the freezer tonight. But look how cute they look.
They turned out great. Hi, so, Jill. Hey, Mary Lou. Hi, Belle.
It tastes so good, especially we had some fresh bread yesterday. So we had them with some fresh bread, and they turned out awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty impressed with you.
Thanks.
A year, 2 years ago, man, Marcy wouldn't have done any of this stuff.
Oh,
she's
my gosh.
Really come out of her shell.
I made jam the first spring we were married.
I'm just saying, I am proud of you for coming out of your shell in many, many, many.
Did you see the lights flicker?
Yeah. In many different ways over the last 2 years.
I have.
Cindy says, is there anywhere around where you can do...
berry picking?
Yeah.
I can't even see that.
Picking strawberries. Not that
no.
I know of.
I was going to say...
We could probably find one, but I don't really want to drive 4 hours.
No, see, and I know there's some up closer to Oklahoma City, which we will do for blueberries especially, because blueberry picking's really fun, and the kids can do blueberry picking. And so we will try to do blueberry picking with them.
Yeah.
And yes, we will be driving the 2.5 hours together to do it.
Sweet.
Love, it's a family activity that then ends up with full bellies and happy kiddos. He doesn't seem too enthusiastic about my plan.
It'll be fun. Be great.
Just remember, I am going down to look at the sun this week.
Yeah, how many of you guys are going to go or be in the eclipse? See the eclipse?
Be in the eclipse.
Be in the eclipse.
Starring Keith. Keith Holman is starring in the eclipse this week.
Oh, somebody asked if I got a haircut. No, I didn't. I'm growing it out.
So is Manbrake.
I guess. Makes Marcy like me more. She thinks I'm attractive. It's true.
I do.
She didn't even deny it.
I didn't. I wasn't going to deny it.
So, yeah, we are going to be doing the eclipse. Fingers crossed.
It's not cloudy.
It's not cloudy. But regardless of whether it's cloudy or not, we are going to be doing a live stream. So if you guys want to mark your calendars, write it down, whatever, we're going to be live streaming the solar eclipse from the zone of totality. So have your notifications on, subscribe, follow along, because that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be actually live streaming it.
I can't remember what time it's at.
It's at like 1 o'clock on Monday.
Okay.
We'll be live probably 30 minutes before.
Yeah. You can watch it with us, and don't forget to get your, eyeglasses.
Yep.
Don't let me forget to bring our eyeglasses.
Patty says going to Illinois. Corey says you should try and train Goose for shed hunting. He is partially trained for it.
He sucks at it too.
He sucks at it too. Yeah. No, I, last year he found a couple,
but that's cause you worked with him.
But I had
year
worked
too
with him on it and done some training and drills and stuff. And this year I never found a shed. So I never, yeah, it took the back burner this year with everything else that I've had going on.
Mostly because hunting season took the front burners.
I hit
burners.
It really, yeah. It,
like multiple burners.
Hunting season burned me out.
Burned me out.
Yeah. So that was the reason why. But yes. I actually have seen this question quite a bit. When will the other goat mama have her babies? I will not be near the eclipse. It won't be seen near Albany, New York. Well, perfect. You can watch it with us. But we do have a video coming on what happened with the other mom and the other baby. What are you doing?
I was trying to look at your calendar, but you don't have one on your computer.
Yeah.
That's so weird.
Why would I use it?
To know what day it is and to be able to look at the calendar.
Okay. You can look right here. It's April 4th.
Well, what day was she supposed to... Her last, like,
April 9th.
April 9th is the last day that she could possibly have a baby goat.
Yes, so we are in a way holding out for that, but
her udder is dried up
and everything, so we're not holding much confidence, but yeah.
But our other two goats are so fun.
Adorable.
So cute. I wish
they're all together now.
I wish they were closer to the house, to be honest. They're kind of far away.
Yeah, when we built the pond, they are far away.
Yeah, I just don't get to see them as much. What I was doing is we would open our window in the morning and I could look out at them. And now I look out at piles and piles of dirt. And yep. Then I look out my front window and I just look at dirt. And I look out the back window and I just look at dirt.
It sounds like you live in like a mine or something.
I do. What do you think it is? It's welcome to Mining with the Eldredges. We don't make as much as
Parker
Schnabel. But just so you know that I just saw on Facebook today that his season 14, they all just got paid.
So they're doing it?
They just finished season 14 and they made all their money and went home.
Nice.
So.
Good to know.
I don't know. That's pretty cool. We're big Gold Rush fans. We sit there at night and that's our show of choice.
Sometimes, yeah.
No, like, we have watched almost every season together.
No way. We've watched like 3 seasons.
Maybe. Not even.
Yeah.
We've definitely watched the last 3 seasons together.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, because this is why when we lived in the apartment, not in the apartment, when we lived in the hotel, that's what we did.
Discovery Channel or whatever.
We would sit there and watch Gold Rush, and then you would watch Oak Island.
I never watched much of that. I hate watching TV. I absolutely despise commercials. He hates
commercials.
I can't stand commercials. Cannot stand them. Yeah.
I don't really like your arm there.
Why? You don't like me cuddling with
like
you?
I feel like I have to lean forward. See? Now don't you? Do you feel
well, yeah, you're pushing me. Why would you push me? I wasn't pushing you. Oh, hi, LG Homestead.
Hi!
Hi, Lori. Hope you're having a wonderful evening.
Lori, we never got to say goodbye to you because we couldn't find you that
Marcy
last day.
Marcy said she didn't want to say goodbye to her.
No. I looked for you that last day of the expo, and I feel like I never got to say goodbye.
Everybody disappeared the last, like, yeah. Everybody was so busy the last day of the expo. It was like people were coming and going and disappearing.
I honestly think we were all exhausted a little bit.
Yeah. We did. We hit it hard the day before.
Well, and it was cold. So, like, for me, I went and not hid in my car, but I went to warm up in my car because the 2 days before that, I was freezing my butt off. And then I'd go inside the building and I could never get warm. And I'd go outside and I couldn't get warm. And so I just went in my car to get warm. And then I fell asleep for like an hour.
Yep. She said, Lori says, I'm having a wonderful evening now that I get to see y'all's live. Yeah, your pants are undone, by the way. Somebody
this
commented.
This is so awkward. You could like whisper and been like, your pants are undone. Mercy.
Well, there's a comment. Everybody can see it. So.
I'm leaving. Nice to meet y'all. Have a great evening.
Oh my gosh. Don't go red, Mars.
I'm so embarrassed. Okay, you can put your shoulder back.
Oh, good. Thank you. Amy says, I love your vlogs from Virginia. Y'all, that's what we are. We're a vlog channel. Daily
okay,
vlog.
Okay, I'm going to share this because now I'm so embarrassed I have to embarrass you.
No.
You know what I was going to embarrass you about, right? Your pants being unzipped.
When?
At church. Do you not remember that?
No.
Never mind.
It wasn't embarrassing enough.
It was embarrassing. You don't
for
remember.
You?
For you. He doesn't remember. It's okay. We all have those moments. And thank you to whoever publicly called me out. That's really embarrassing. We're going to retitle this
live. Everybody's just laughing. They think it's funny.
Well, at least they couldn't see
go down
anything.
Hit the thumbs up button if you guys think it was funny.
Okay. Let's talk about Colonel's epic mistake last week. He agreed that we would jump in the pond. It was an epic
mistake.
It was.
I I made a big mistake.
So he was like, okay, if we get 2,000 likes, we're going to jump in the pond. Like, that's a great idea. So he agreed to it on a video. Not even, I did not confirm.
No, you did.
I said.
You said, I guess if we do it.
I said, yeah, we'll have to talk about what number. Well, he then in the video is like, yeah, 2,000 likes. You guys, our average videos, which we're so grateful for, get above 2,000 likes.
I had no idea. I was like, I threw it out there. I was like, I don't know. Like, I bet we usually get 1,000 or whatever, so we'll say 2,000. No, like a video that gets a lot of views for us will have 3,000 or 4,000
likes, which we're so grateful
for. Which is awesome. But I totally undershot it.
We're going to jump in the pond no matter what.
So now we got to jump in the pond. So make sure you're following along for that, because as soon as it rains enough to fill it up, I guess we're going for a swim.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was bad.
When you told me, I was just like, are you kidding me?
Yeah. Next time we'll change it. We'll up it a little bit. Make it a little bit of a challenge. Goodness gracious.
But we're grateful there was for like, everybody who...
Within like 3 hours of it being posted, the video being posted, I saw a comment. Oh, we're already at 1,100 likes. Can't wait to see you jump in the pond. And that's when I realized, I was like, I wonder how many likes we usually get. And so I went and looked, and then I was like, yeah. Or screwed. So there was no hope. But that brings us to the pond. The pond is...
done.
Is it done? I don't know if I would call it done. Is it done? The dirt work...
Well, I don't know. It's
your... I don't either. The dirt work is all done. So it's... the pond is done. It's built. You know, there's obviously all of the things that we're going to do to Emerald Island. We're basically at a standstill until we know if it holds water or not. Because I don't want to dump a bunch of time, money, all of that kind of stuff into it if it doesn't hold water. Because if it doesn't hold water, I've got to start over.
Well, and I will bring this up right now because obviously we're putting a fence around it, but the fence isn't there. The pond is empty.
Yeah.
But there's one part of it, you know, where you have that little spot full of water.
Yeah.
And there's like that big hill.
Yeah.
I caught your son midway falling down that hill today. Paxton.
Oh my gosh.
We went out to go look at the animals and he kind of just like stumbled and then just like, I mean, it's not like, and the water's like this deep, but it's a little steep right there. We may need to fix that just a little
bit. Well, that'll all be fenced off. I mean, I guess
yeah,
I could try.
Yeah, but like, even if you have an animal, like that's.
I know it is. It is.
It's steep. Really steep right there. And so. If they like went into like, you know,
yeah,
down 4 feet.
I don't know, but
so, we might need to fix that part of the pond.
Yeah, there, like I said, there's going to be some adjusting. But the best news ever is I decided to rent the skid steer for a month instead of a week.
It's the best news ever.
So because we got into these projects and I was like, oh my gosh, this is going to take way too long. This is going to be too like we're not going to be able to get done everything. So I called them up and they. It's if you buy it for 3 weeks, you basically get it for four. You get the fourth week free. So I was like, I guess we're gonna do it. So that's what we did. So we have it. So what I'm hoping is we're supposed to get rain on Tuesday, Wednesday this week, or this coming week. I'm hoping it rains, fills up with water. If it leaks, then I can figure out what the issue is before we get rid of the skid steer. Use the skid steer to go in and actually clean it. Your phone's about to die, which I don't know how we're gonna do this. Hold on. Sorry, y'all. Let's see.
Okay, sorry, Facebook.
Oh my gosh. Okay, don't move. Okay, I did. Gamer 18 says, are you guys going to be adding fish to the pond? Yes, I really, really hope so.
After we jump in it.
After we jump in it, yes. And there were a lot of comments and stuff of people being concerned that, oh gosh.
We missed those.
Yeah. That, you know, we were going to swim in there and it was going to have the duck poop and all that kind of stuff. Guys, I don't think we're really going to swim in it except for like the first time it fills up. So that's kind of what we're
going
for.
It's kind of a bummer because I was going to get these cute floaties that I could look outside and see my pretty pond.
But that's going to have to be a different pond.
Our animals need a place to swim
and be ducks. So it'll look pretty with the ducks out there swimming around and their little island with all their little houses and
yeah,
something like that, right?
I thought it was going to be one house. Are we doing multiple houses?
Well, it just depends. We haven't decided yet on what design we're doing. Hi, Matthew. Hi, Christine. Hi, Robin. Sorry we keep freezing over on Facebook.
Oh, that could also be because you swiped down.
Oh, yeah.
Just now. Because he had to plug in my phone because it was dying.
Chester says, hello from Mountain Home, Arkansas. Good work on your property. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Like we've been talking about, it's fun to go out there, and I love doing dirt work. I love it. I think it's because of the visual progress, and there's been a lot of it lately. So if you guys haven't seen the latest video, go check it out as soon as we're done here, because it goes into the depth of what we're doing on the front yard and stuff, and it looks absolutely amazing. You guys are not going to want to miss it.
I don't want to miss it either. Like last night, what was I doing last night?
You're on the phone.
I was on the phone and he was working on it, and then it got too dark and I couldn't see what it looked like when it was done, and I was so disappointed that I couldn't see it until later. But then I came home from the boys' doctors, which we'll talk about right now.
Oh yeah.
And it looked so good. It does look so good. You did
an excellent job. And it functions.
Yeah. And okay, this was a sure genius moment. It was yesterday, right? And I said, Crandall, the way that this and this are going on it, I really like that. And what if we redid this? Like, we did this instead?
Well, we can tell. Originally, right now, we have kind of a U driveway. Well, before. We used to have a U driveway so you could pull in, turn around, and go out.
Not even turn around.
It was a half circle.
And it was so nice, especially for, like, our UPS man and our FedEx truck.
Well, we had said, okay, we're just going to have it come in, hook, and there'll be a big gravel spot where you can turn around and go back out the same way.
Like an L, but with a little circle.
Yeah, a place to turn around at the end. Well, neither of us really loved that idea, but we were like, I don't know what else we could do. Like, because we don't want to have two gates. We only want to have one gate onto the property, all of that.
But I didn't really want, like, a little circle either. Like, I wasn't too fond of just, like, all of that look.
Yeah.
And then...
So what Marcy decided is to do like a number 6, where you come in here, you drive around a big loop, and then you can go back out the same way. And that's what I did, and it's amazing.
Mm-hmm. And it only is amazing because of all of the girt work, the dirt work that Crandall has done, and like the layering and the...
Yeah, it's terrace. So like you walk out of our house, and the dirt now slopes away, so we're not going to have any more flooding issues.
Which, if you haven't seen our flooding issues, go check out our Facebook reel from today and like 3 days ago. When you go over to our Facebook page, you can click on reel. And like, you'll see it's a video of Crandall and I out in the rain. And you can literally see all of the water that we're standing in right outside of our house. Facebook, you just froze again. I know. Hopefully you're unfrozen.
Yeah.
So it was like this much water that day.
Yeah.
And that was just like an average storm.
Yeah, we had an average storm. There'll be 3 or 4 inches of water out there. So now it slopes away. The driveway comes through there, and then it goes up 2 or 3 feet, and then that's where the other top loop of the driveway is, and then it goes out. So it is. It's terraced into 3 different levels, which is, it looks really good. But Marcy also said we need to put in like an aquascapes pond there, which we're not doing right now. But if we ever decide to down the road, we're going to have some pretty good looking landscaping in the front yard. So.
Like, I thought like a little area that we can put chairs out on or something, like in between that.
We're trying to make this a property that
you want to be at.
That you want to be at. That's super, like you show up and you're like, wow. And even driving in where it's all dirt right now, but like the pond is in. The driveway is in, all that kind of stuff. I do. I'm like, wow, like this is going to look absolutely amazing. Gamer 18, build a pond. You can swim, race fish in, and make a waterfall. That would be sweet. I think, honestly, that's possible, but it would need to be a whole lot bigger than we have it right now, which I don't have the equipment. If we were to do that, we would need a bulldozer. I don't have access to one or anything like that, and it would be more work. Like, I just don't have the resources and stuff to do that right now. Sharon says, my 3 dots don't offer a thumbs up. Mine is under the video. I'm on the laptop, not on the phone. Oh, yeah, I saw you guys going back and forth about how to actually thumbs up the video, which I have no idea.
I don't know.
I assume you just click the button that looks like this. That's the one you click. Oh, my gosh. Cindy says, just don't flip it. You've done it remarkable on this land, as in fixing this place up. Okay.
Oh, flipping the home.
So the plan has been, because this house isn't big enough, that we're going to have to upgrade at some point. Now, there's a couple of different options that we've been talking about. Well, you guys are getting the inside scoop on this
live. Our living space, like, our kitchen is big enough. Our family room is big enough. But you guys don't really see, like, our bathrooms ever, or, like, our closet. It's mostly us. Like, our closet and our bathroom is Harry Potter small. Like,
yeah, so our...
our bathroom's his broom
for
closet.
For a master bedroom bathroom, it's not great. It's terrible. And then, like, we don't have an extra room for a toy room or for the boys. So, oh my gosh.
Or, like, when... because all of my family lives out of state, and all of, like, his parents are close, but all of his siblings live out of state too. So when we have guests come, like, there's no room for, like, them either. So
yeah, they just have to crash in the living room, which isn't great because it's connected to the rest of the house.
Yeah.
So we have a couple of options. Option one is we have an acre or so of clear land over, like, I don't know, 500 yards from our current house, to where we could fence this lot off, like, do an acre around this house, sell just the house and, like, an acre of land, and build a new house over there. We could move all together, or what we talked about last night is actually adding on to this house and adding, how much square foot did we say, like 600 or something?
300.
Basically, we would add it would be a hallway and then a master suite. So master closet, master bedroom, and master bathroom.
It's called primary.
Okay, primary. I can be politically correct, I guess. I don't know.
It is called primary.
So that's kind of an idea that we threw around. You guys know we're very good at throwing around ideas and dreams.
And most of the time we execute them with a lot of other stuff going on.
You've pretty much got me sold. I mean, it would go right off the back of our kitchen.
It's crazy that he's saying I sold him on this idea, because I asked if we could do this idea right when we moved into the house. Like, literally.
Yeah, but
right,
think
when
about
we
where
in.
We were when we started. There was so much to
You're
be done.
You're still shaking the...
There was so much to be done. Like, it's just too overwhelming to try and worry about it.
My laundry room still doesn't have paint. And the bathroom. Okay. And the boys' bathroom still doesn't
have
paint.
Yeah, but we have
There's
walls.
There's still so much to
We
be
have
done.
Walls. We have paint. We have a kitchen. We have a bathroom. We have...
the exterior of our house needs to be redone.
Yeah, there's still obviously a bunch of stuff that needs to be done, but we're like 90% there compared to where we started.
That's true.
So... yeah, Barb says, I would add on or build like a guest house for your guests. I do want to do a guest house. And we've talked about doing that in the shop, of having like a little guest house, which that could still...
I guess that's where I'll keep my clothes.
That's where you'll keep me, I guess. Sharing...
Guys, let's get honest right now. I think Crandall has never slept on the couch. If you have...
like two or three times.
Yes, because you were sick. There was like two or three times.
No, I think one time I got mad enough at you to go sleep out there.
Yeah, that's like one time.
We do pretty good.
We do.
At not getting mad at each
other. We do
like
98% good.
98% good?
Yeah, 98%.
Sharon says, if you're going to add on, make it worth your while and do at least 600 to 800 square feet, even if it takes a while. Yeah, that's, I think.
600 to 800 square feet.
Yep.
How big is that? That's like this whole area. That's like 600. That's half of our house.
That's huge. Yeah, because our house is 1600 square feet, 1700 square feet.
And
so,
our Logan house was 950.
You know what we could do? That would look so bad though. I was gonna say we could do a master bedroom bathroom addition over here and a garage over here.
Garage doesn't count.
That's true, because it's not livable space. But then I was like, but then you'd walk out the back door, and it would be like a tunnel. Like, there'd be a house
on
either side.
It would be like Bruce and Marianne's house.
Yeah, but it would be way deeper than that. Theirs is only like 5 feet. That would be super, super deep.
So, and that's the other thing is we run into the aspect of like current, like the worst thing is redoing projects that you've already done. So we don't really want to touch our laundry room. We don't really want to touch our bathroom. We
don't want to touch the kitchen.
We're not touching the kitchen. Sorry. Only thing that we touch in the kitchen is the back door. So.
But that being said, we would not have to do much. We would have to close off two windows in the bedroom, but there would still be the one. We'd have to close off the bathroom window and the one of the bedroom windows. But that would be like literally a sheetrock patch. So it would not be bad at all. And then we'd have to take down the big pecan tree that's in the back of our house, which is over our house anyways.
But I don't know what you do about that root system.
Nothing. You get out what you can.
You're pouring concrete on top of it.
No, you'd rip it all out.
You just said you get out what you can.
Yeah. You're not going to get everything, but it's going to be all right. You pour your footings and foundation. It's not going to keep growing. So it's not going to crack. What would happen is if it died and decayed over 15, 20 years, then it would sink. So just make sure you do your concrete really good.
Okay. I mean, people used to build their houses on tree stumps all the time.
Yeah, exactly. Tree houses. Is that what you were saying?
Good. No, but that was good. So, but that being said, that is not the plan. Do not take that for
what? That's one of those things you'll see a video like, I destroyed our house, will be the title of it or something. And that's when you'll know that I started into the project.
But we're. I feel like the problem is so
like
far
in my mind now. I'm like, that would be so fun. Like I want to do that. Like I want to get plans drawn up, get it all engineered, because I've never done that side of it. I've never had plans and engineering, which we would have to get done for this. We actually don't have any permits or codes or anything out here in the county, which is a problem, and it makes things nice because you can get stuff done easier. But I obviously would want it to be done right and to be done good, so we would take the time and everything to make sure that it was done that way. But yeah, I think I would love to learn how to do all of that stuff, because eventually I'll be building our next house 10, 20 years from now or whatever, I'm sure. Yeah.
We froze. You are?
I don't know.
Wait, you are going to build our next house? I don't really want to.
Zan the Goat says, in the new area, have an underground bunker in the garage. We do want to do that. We do want to do a storm shelter. I'm hoping while we have the skid steer that I'll actually be able to put one in. Although we don't have any plans for it yet. They're very expensive, so.
Maybe we Etsy some?
Yeah. I can DIY it, and I plan to DIY it, but, I mean, you're still talking probably at least $1,500.
It's our lives, though. Can we get two bathtubs?
Oh, my gosh. Make a coffin?
Yeah. Cut a hole in it.
Yeah, and you're going to fit all five of us in two bathtubs?
Make five coffins.
Terrible idea, Marsh. Terrible.
It was a cool idea. And then bury those. Like little cocoons. Maybe that's what we do for our deck house.
What?
Two bathtubs?
That's just look like trash.
I feel like these little.
No. Sorry, Morris. Veto. Veto.
Veto.
Urban American Homestead. Hey, y'all from Ohio. It's Julie and Andy.
Hi, Julie and Andy.
Welcome, welcome.
But is it really both Julie and Andy?
Gamers 18, what kind of fish do you raise? He says, wait, I lost the comment here. Family business, we raise fish and sell them. Hey, where are you? Do you live close to here? Can we buy some fish from you?
We're in Oklahoma.
We're in Oklahoma.
You
Southern Oklahoma.
Okay.
Maybe make the house your... Make this house the guest house is, I think, what Corey is saying. Make this house the guest house and then build your dream house. See, that's not a bad idea either. Just leave this one how it is.
I mean, wow, that would be a really nice guest kitchen.
It'd be a nice guest house. I
really like our kitchen.
I'm glad.
I do. I really love our backsplash.
It's big.
Yes.
I love how big it is.
Yes. I was just talking to a lady from church. and we might have a tamale making night and or a tamale making day. And she's like, but I don't know where we could do it. Like, nobody really has a big enough kitchen. And I was like, I do. Like, I do. I do have a big enough kitchen. I was like, we could fit like 10 people around my island. And then I have all my other countertops.
Easy.
Like,
yeah.
And a table. So
I'm glad we did.
You did so good, love.
I'm glad we spaced it out enough that the island was far,
yeah,
farther
we
than
both,
normal.
You
can
both
have easy have two
there.
People go past it. Like, yeah. You can have people around the island and have people walk around still. That sucks. I remember growing up in our house, if somebody was standing in between the countertop and the island, they would have to move for you to go around.
Oh, really? Yours was that close?
Yeah.
Ours wasn't that bad, but it, like, here you could bolt, like, two people could be standing in the countertop and someone still could walk through. Like,
yep.
There's that much of a difference.
Lori says, how much land are you on? We are on 20 acres.
But we only use 5 of it.
Yeah, well, around, yeah. The rest, most of it's pasture, hunting land. But around the house, yeah. There's a couple of acres. And then, because the problem is our house is here. And then if, you know, we've got like 3 or 4 acres around the house. And then after that, it drops off a hill and goes down into a creek. A dry season creek, a wet season creek. It gets full of water
creek.
When it rains, and that's it. So that makes it really hard to be over there.
So Carol asked, well, she said that Matt's really good, like really good help, and then talks about your phone dropping while you were on
clearly
the trip.
You don't watch our videos, Marsh.
I changed diapers.
Yeah, my phone fell out of the skid steer when we were digging, and it fell. But it was all good. See, we're still using it.
Can Maverick know?
Yeah, he likes
guys,
silver.
He's
my favorite.
He's so much fun. And I know we're not supposed to have favorite kids. I tell him he's my favorite 3-year-old.
I mean, I like the other boys just as much, but I enjoy that he can
do things.
He goes out every day and works with me all day. Marcy's like, it's time for his nap or time for quiet time. I'm like, why? He can just stay out here with me.
Because of that. And he knows that you're going to say that.
I know. I'm like, I don't care. He can hang out with me. I'll babysit him.
It's not. They're all. Oh, give it 10 seconds. Let's wait. Roast him. It's not babysitting if it's your own child.
But I mean, like, watching him.
Yeah.
I mean, I just say babysitting because that's
what
I mean.
But the thing
is watching.
Then, like, today you're gone during his quiet time and he's like, I just want to be with Dad.
Yeah.
I don't want to go to quiet time. And I'm like, wait, I need quiet time because I have to do the dishes and do this, do that. And I need a break.
Okay, speaking of the twins, give them the rundown on Paxton and Harvey's doctor's appointment.
Oh, we forgot.
Oh, it says, Sheila said, the boys are getting so big so fast.
Okay,
and,
so
yeah,
I took the
literally.
Boys today for their 16-month checkup. Can we believe it's been 16 months? I feel like I've aged that much.
I feel like I've aged 3 years.
Yeah, but they did so good. I was kind of nervous. This was my first doctor's appointment with them. I've pretty much always taken them by myself. But this was the first doctor's appointment that they've both been out of car seats. Like, they're too big for their little carry car seats. And so I had to like take them both in and they go in their cute little shoes and it's so cute.
They look like little ducklings.
And the shorts, I wish we'll have to post a picture of them, but they're wearing like the cutest little outfits and like shorts and you can see all of like Paxton's rolls. So cute. And I just like put them and it's hard because you like take one out of the car and I like have to hold them while I unbuckle the other one and then I carry them like this and then I set them down on the sidewalk and I hold their hands and we walk in together and they did really good but they were walking really slow and I was like they need like a mom of twins parking space because it was just like forever we had to walk so long and they get in and they like did great checking in and did such a good job. Like Paxton goes in to like get weighed and she's like, do you think he'll go up there? And I was like, oh yeah. And he like steps on it and then she like takes his temperature, checks his head, and I feel so bad because she's like, the temperature thing is just like a skin thing, and she like takes it off, cleans it, and I was like, you can use the same one on him. Like, I don't care. And she's like, no, like, it's okay. And then, like, measures his head and has to, like, throw that away and then change her gloves. And I'm like,
between the two kids.
They're like, I'm touching both of their hands. Like, yeah. They're the same kid. And then I set Harvey down, and Harvey, like, goes on this scale, and Paxton would not get off. Like, he did not want to get off scale. Like, he just wanted to be up there because it has, like, these handrails, and he just was playing on it and, like, just cried so hard when we took him off, and it was really cute. But they did really good. They only tried to get in
the
trash
can analytics, twice. Mars. That's what we're waiting for.
No, they're all... I was super stressed, and they did awesome, and I'm proud of them for it. They listened so well, and I didn't know they could listen that well. Like,
they're definitely
like,
coherent.
Harvey, don't do that. And Paxton would keep doing whatever he's doing, and then Harvey would come and leave it, and I'd be like, Pax, no, like, they know their own names. They know what to do and stuff. And so we'll start with Harvey, because last time we started with Paxton, Harvey's a very, I mean, this is, like, a good way. He's very average for kids his age. So
size-wise.
He's 23 pounds. And he's 32 inches tall. Okay?
So which is like average. 60% tile.
Yeah,
he's
49th in weight and 60th in height, or 50 in height. Like, very just right around the 50s. Paxton, he's so cute. He is 27 and a half pounds, which is in the 94th percentile in weight, which isn't, like, a bad thing. And like I said, they're both very well proportioned. And then in his height, he's 34 and a half inches, so he actually is... not even on the chart. He's so tall.
He's in the 99
and up.
99 and up percentile.
Percentile.
Isn't it for his head too?
His head's 96th. Jeez. Like, so very well proportioned.
But he's
child,
just
but
a
huge
kid. Huge.
And
hunk.
She, like, it was so funny because the doctor would, like, say something to him, or she handed him something, a sticker at the end, and he just goes, duh, duh. And she's like, what? And he's like, thank you. Like, he makes two syllables to say thank you.
Yep.
And then Harvey, she handed one to Harvey, and Harvey did the same thing. And I was just like, do you know how to say thank you? Like, and it's becoming instinctive, which, like, Maverick is very good at saying thank you. So.
Yeah. It's really cute. You give him anything, and he does. Sometimes it comes out like thank you, and sometimes it's just two syllables, and you know that's... Yeah. Did it. Thank you.
But Harvey also... Was it Harvey yesterday in the car? You guys know we're a big Top Gun family. No, that's not what we named Maverick after, but we are a big Top Gun family. And Maverick really likes the song. And only the part of the song. Fly into the danger zone. Yesterday in the car, was it Harvey?
Harvey was singing
da, 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 dun, da, dun.
Literally.
Like, over
like
and
six
over
or
and
seven
over.
Times.
And I was like, is that Danger Zone? And we, like, listened again. And Maverick's like, he's singing Danger Zone. And they say, like, did it together. Cutest thing.
Well, it's really cute when Maverick picks up what they're saying, like, before we do or before we say anything. So it's like, oh, it's not just us that think they're saying
that.
It. Like, Maverick is actually picking up on it, too.
Yeah. And
it was so cute.
They like to play with the potatoes. And the other day, Paxton's in there. Or one of them was in there counting. Every time. And I was like, he's trying to count. He's trying to count.
Yeah.
Like, it's so
cute.
Well,
no, and same thing. We were in the car. And we were talking. And we were counting. Yeah, it was like, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then Harvey or Paxton, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, they didn't say the number, but you could tell.
You could tell that
syllables.
That's what they were doing.
Yeah.
And it's just been a lot of fun. It's hard to, like, not give in to them when they're so cute. Like, today, for example, Pax was being so cute while he was eating, but he wasn't eating. He was just throwing his food.
Oh, because he loves the reaction we give him when he throws his food. And we say, no, Paxton, you do not
throw
your food. And he goes, and he's, and it's like, okay, never mind. Do it if you want. We won't say anything.
Do your eyes like Pax, how he does. Like, that's literally Pat. When Pax opens his eyes, like, what are you going to do, Mom? It's Crandall's exact, like, eyes.
Really?
Like, oh, yes. He looks just like you. And he's like,
cheeky, cheeky.
Like, you give to Maverick, like, when Maverick's doing something, you give him, like, the side eye. That's Pax. And drops it.
So, and then Harvey will bust up laughing. And then Harvey will drop it, and Pax will start laughing. And they're getting to that point.
Feed off of each other. We're going to have to... what if we put one over here and one over there? Yeah. So then they don't know what the other one's
doing.
They've
started feeding off of each other. It's stupid cute, but it's annoying. Also annoying.
But Pax hasn't climbed out of his bed again. So far...
he bonked his head pretty good, so I'm not surprised.
Well, no, he tries every day.
Oh.
Yeah, he tries every day. But I've been sticking socks, like really like knee-high socks. So it takes a lot of effort for him to get them off. And then in the morning, because he fell out in the morning, we go in pretty quick now. And I do watch him, like we have a little monitor that I've turned the camera on. So then we can see, I watch him at nap time if he's playing. But it makes me nervous because, well, I just need to order another sound machine so I can have that cord back. But we don't have a camera currently on Harvey, but I can hear him still through the monitor. And so, like, what if one day he just learns how to crawl out of his bed?
We'll find out.
I know. It just makes me nervous.
Joe Lotto says, Crandall needs a skid steer for his birthday. In 1 year, he would have his entire property into an amusement park. What a great idea. You read my mind.
What did you ask for your birthday?
Well, I wanted an RC rock crawler truck.
That's right.
But, I was thinking about that, and I was like, man, if I did have a skid steer, like, that's going to be one of the first pieces of equipment I buy when we win the lottery, because there's so much that I can do with it. It'll be that and then a dirt bike, so that I can go build a track with the skid steer and then jump on the dirt bike and go ride it. And I cannot wait. One day I'll be able to afford a skid steer, and we're going to have the most amazing property ever, because that's exactly what I want to do. I want to build our property into a recreational heaven. I want to have gigantic... You guys are going to get the rundown. I want to have a dirt bike track.
Welcome to our dreams.
Welcome to our dreams. And you're going to see this in our property.
We're
now
manifesting it.
We're manifesting it. We're doing it on a smaller scale. Eventually, we are going to buy a new property, you know, buy 300 or 500 acres.
We really just hope we can buy the neighbors across the street.
That's true. But we want to be able to buy a property where I can put in a full-sized motocross track, supercross track, enduro track. I'm gonna have a giant slip and slide that comes down a hill. I actually have a reel about this on one that I went to, and I was like, I'm putting this on my property one day. Giant slip and slide into a pond. It'll be a good clean pond that you can swim in. It'll have a trampoline out in the middle. It'll have a giant rope swing.
He just it's wants to live loaded on like
Redneck heaven. Yeah, that's where you're going to make it. So, anyways, all of that. I mean, we're gonna have whatever you can imagine. One day, you stay following the channel. You're gonna see it come to fruition. Might take some years.
What's fruition?
That means it's gonna come to pass.
Oh,
it's gonna happen.
I didn't know that.
So that's, yeah, it's going to be a legit place where like all of our friends and family can come hang out, have a bunch of fun swimming, biking, dirt biking, riding four wheelers, whatever you want to do, hunting, fishing, all of the above. Tammy says, by the time you have enough money to do all that, you'll be too old to enjoy it. No way.
Well, you got to remember, Crandall does everything himself, so...
It's a lot cheaper.
It's a lot cheaper when he's out there. You know, if we were to go get somebody to move the dirt that we're moving now, it would be...
It'd be okay, 3 or 4 times the cost.
Basically,
of what, it is.
What...
And it wouldn't have been done the way that I wanted it.
Yeah, so we got a guy who came out and estimated how much it would be to do our front yard, to re-slope our front yard for us and dig the pond, right?
Yeah.
And it was the cost of what it costed us to rent the skid steer for a month. So now we have the skid steer for the entire month and get to do a bunch of other projects and get to like really do this instead of just like the bare minimum. And we have it for an entire month
Yeah, because the front yard is done, the pond is done. I mean, within a day or two, those are done, and we still have 2.5 weeks of the skid steer, and so we got to put in roads and trails and all that stuff.
Yeah, so the dirt bike track, I mean, ours is looking pretty good outside our front of our house. He just wants one a little bit bigger.
Well, yeah, it's not, if you're going to, it's going to be great for Maverick, and it would be fun to go putt around on. You guys haven't even seen it yet. They don't even know what we're talking about. But yes, we have a motocross track in our front yard now.
It's
the side of our yard. And where the goats used to be. It's going to be perfect. It's like a good little pit bike track. It'll be good for Maverick and the boys, but I need jumps like 4 times that big for actual riding.
It'll be good for me.
Actually, yeah, it would.
It's like,
you guys ready for motocross Marcy? We can put that on a shirt. Moto mom. Yeah.
Moto mommy.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, he would love it.
Oh yeah.
We gotta get, the problem is Colonel's been so busy the last, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, that we don't really often get to go outside together with the kids, and we gotta get Paxton out there and put him on a bike.
On a bike.
Or clean that bike.
And bring it, we just need to buy a new one. That one's, Maverick's trashed that bike. I mean, we've had it for 3 years.
And
so
he's used it like it's his best friend.
Yeah.
Too. So.
The boys are due for him. Their own balance bikes. But thank you guys so much for joining. Hopefully we got to everything that we had talked about. I'm sure we're missing something, but that's kind of what we have going on right now. We're going to keep landscaping, getting some, you know, those outdoor projects done, taken care of. And then dirt bike track is coming. Once this pond holds water, we're going to have a whole series where it's going to be Maverick's pond for him to like
learn
how to do everything. He's going to learn about stocking fish. He's going to learn about aeration. He's going to learn about filtration, about shelters. What?
I love that you say this. Like, it's just, and I think in our heads, we don't realize that our twins are getting so old, because by next summer, they'll get to learn this
stuff.
They'll
be doing
too.
The same thing.
So
yeah.
Really, like, it's Mavericks right now, but in 7-8 months, like, Maverick will be where you guys started watching Maverick, which was 1.5 years ago. And so, like, by the beginning of next summer, like, Maverick, the twins will be able to do it, too.
Yeah. So, I mean, we're going to take him along on the whole thing, kind of teach him and teach ourselves, because I don't really know what I'm doing either. So, we're all going to figure it out together. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this live. Go down, comment, like, subscribe, all those things. Share. It helps us out so much. Helps spread our reach. Bring other people to our family. We want to join you guys, welcome you guys into our family. So thanks so much. We'll see you guys on the next video.
Bye, everybody.